Phogat said she does not believe she lost to B. Wants to really plant her flag on Lin Heqin here.
Nice little rip and slip by Ritu as she threw the right hand and immediately came underneath the counter shot. That was impressive. That could have been the surprise she was talking about, is that head movement she's been working on a lot.
The hands of Ritu are very high here, Mitch, exposing her ribs. Very high and wide guard. And you see there, Lin Heqin went to the rib cage.
Lin Heqin is a very talented striker. She's got a long range style and she utilizes her reach very well. I like the kicks that she's throwing early on. She's already connected with body kicks and leg kicks. She's also light on her feet. She's circling around. She's not giving Ritu a stagnant target, especially because Ritu loves that double leg takedown so much.
Nice sticky jab there from Lin. Inside leg kick. Circles off counterclockwise. Good movement from the Chinese athlete. Don't forget, folks, our main event tonight, the strawweight Muay Thai world title, Muay Thai Mega Clash, Prajin Chai. Sam A. Looks for the takedown now. Does Ritu Phogat double leg? Can she sink it?
She's nice and tight on those hips. She looks like she has her hands clasped together. Let's see if Lin Heqin can defend. She's got a nice wide stance. She gets that underhook on that side. Let's see if she can pry Ritu up. That she does. She creates a little bit of separation and frames off the face.
Nice little popping right hand there from Ritu.
This is good takedown defense right here from Lin Heqin.
Yeah,
see if she can
Sanders
circle
stylist.
Off.
Not wanting to go to ground with this star wrestler. Wisely slow dragon.
Yeah, it's, you know, Sanda does have a lot of good throws. It's similar to judo in the throwing aspect that they have. And they utilize the heavy hips really well to defend those takedowns.
Have you ever had the chance to roll with Ritu at Evolve MMA?
Nah, she's the one I never really got to roll with. I was always getting beat up by Zhang Jingnan.
Jab two there from Lin Heqin. Overhand, nicely done from Lin, using her reach as well. This is what a tall fighter needs to do. Use that God-given gift of length to effect. Pulls down the head, hoping to rise a knee, tuck it up to the jaw of Ritu.
I like those combinations thrown by Lin Heqin, as she's able to put hand combinations together with the leg kicks. And that's what Ritu waited for. She waited to time that leg kick, create the momentum to move forward, and now she's got a bad spot for Lin Heqin to be in. She's got that scarf hold. She's trying to shove that arm between her legs and look for a possible key lock on the arm with the legs. There's an arm bar too. Lin Heqin's trying to sneak around the backside, maybe take the back of Ritu.
Lots of instructions coming from Ritu's corner here, Dragon.
Yeah, she's attempting to get that arm. She's really going after that arm, but what she did is she allowed Lin Heqin to sneak around and get the half guard on that side. That's like one of the first moves that they teach you in BJJ, is how to take somebody's back if they have the headlock. Ritu's fully committed to this headlock right now. She's trying to shove the arm, Lin Heqin's left arm in between her legs to go for a key lock from what's called the scarf hold. But she's having a hard time doing it because Lin is squirming out the backside and she uses it to get back up to her feet.
This is where Lin Heqin wants to be. An early taste of what Ritu is capable of on the ground, though not a full taste, not the full course, the full meal.
1 minute left in the first round.
Center circle. 1 minute left. Nice inside leg kick that gets out of the way of the possible counter. She throws the strikes fast, clean, Lin Heqin.
That little grappling taste that you were talking about really tells these young ladies a lot about each other. You know, it tells, you know, Lin Heqin that how dominant Ritu is and how strong she is on top. But it also tells Ritu that, you know, Lin Heqin, she's very sneaky and she's got to be a little bit tighter in her control.
Overhand right from Ritu, had some power behind it. Jab two from Lin, good extension, front kick off the back leg. Overhand right, left hook from Ritu, misses. Nice uppercut, just clipped the nose there. Lin Heqin beating Ritu Phogat in the striking. Ritu really coming up with that right. Outside leg kick, that one to the back of the leg, around that sciatic nerve. End of the round, we got on the towels. Round from Lin Heqin of China. Ritu relying on that right hand. Guard up very high again. Interesting to see if Lin Heqin can start going to the ribs maybe with her kicks with the long legs. Jab two there from Lin Heqin. Good right hand again. Mandible rattler. Outside leg kick from Lin. A little bit more tempo now from these two women.
Lots of forward pressure coming from Ritu. You can see she's trying to back Lin Heqin up against the wall there so she can shoot that takedown. She almost uses the wall as like an extra limb to secure these takedowns.
Mitch, at what stage do you feel frustration may creep in on Ritu if she can't affect any takedowns here on Lin?
I don't know. She's already got one successful takedown. You know, so right here, this is going to be important for your point, Michael. If Lin Heqin is able to stop this takedown, it's going to, you know, it's going to start to wear on Ritu because she's trying so hard to get there. You know, she backs her up well, she gets her pinned up against the circle, and then she's able to do this, Michael. So her confidence has got to be high because right now she's been successful on a majority of her takedown attempts.
Just trying to create space there, Lin Heqin, to no avail though. Ritu straight back on top of her inside the guard. Close now from Lin Heqin. So if you're in Lin's corner, what are you telling her right now, Dragon?
I like how she puts the feet on the hips, right? She does not stay in closed guard. She's just not locking her legs and holding Ritu in this locked position because that's where Ritu wants to be with the ground and pound. Lin Heqin immediately opens her guard and starts to threaten, right? She's looking to have the feet on the hips, push Ritu off, create that little bit of space, or at least start to create movement. I would expect Lin Heqin to start walking her legs up and looking for submissions.
Nicely timed and placed left hand there from Ritu Phogat. Trying to go to side control. The Indian gets there now. Pins that leg. What's Ritu looking for here, Dragon?
Ritu's looking for side control. She's trying to get past. Right now she's almost in three-quarter mount. See how she still has one foot kind of in the guard, but I think she could pop that right out. Yeah, she does. Now she's in side control. So now she's trying to go to her bread and butter, which is that crucifix. She's gonna try to take that arm, that left arm of Lin Heqin right there, put it down in between her leg, hold it there, and then drop ground and pound. Lin Heqin knew what was going on, right? She keeps her arms tight into her body and then starts wall walking to create that scramble. Let's see if she can get it done here. You can walk along the wall, you just can't put your toes inside the cage area.
Mitch, can you put your toes behind the sponsors padding like Lin Heqin was then?
As long as she doesn't grab the fence part with her toes, right, she's okay. You can see the Lin Heqin's kind of got, I think, an inverted triangle here. Does Ritu have both of her arms free? Yeah, she's just got the like a head scissors position here with the head. She might use it to roll out, but Ritu's going to be okay and settle down into side control.
Good view of the side control position for Ritu Phogat. A lot of options available to the Indian Tigress from here. India being such a power nation in one championship over the last 12 months. Of course, their first world champion came along not long ago. Arjun Bullitt defeating Brandon Vera for the world heavyweight title. What a moment. Congratulations from all over the world, including from the Prime Minister of Canada. Cuts in the hips again here. Pins that arm, exposes the face of Lin Heqin. This is Ritu Phogat's bread and butter. This is what she does. And Lin Heqin, no place to go. Trying to control the posture. Trying to close down those hands of Ritu Phogat.
Yeah, Ritu is very strong in this position, and we're seeing exactly that. She's very dominant in that side control position. She's trying to take the left arm and pin it down and hold it down with her legs. But Lin Heqin is very active inside this position. She can't really get out of this position, but she's doing a good job of really preventing Ritu from doing a lot of damage. You can see the kind of the reddening that's starting on her face. That's from these short strikes that Ritu's landing.
Certainly been a tremendous 5 minutes for Ritu Phogat. Was by decision. It was razor close. Is this going to go to decision in Singapore again for Ritu Phogat? Or can she find a way to finish Lin Heqin? Front kick there from Lin. Outside thigh kick, Ritu looked for the counter right. Jab to overhand right there from Lin. Ritu sticks the jab to the midsection, eats that one. You hear the corner of Ritu saying, move your head, to avoid the precise needling jab of Lin Heqin.
Yeah, Ritu built up, a significant lead in those final minutes there, like minute 8 through 10. She was able to do a lot of good work with the ground and pound, with the ground control, getting inside control, and I think that really added to her lead at this point. So Lin Heqin is gonna have to do something significant in these last 3 or 4 minutes.
That exquisite jab of Lin Heqin has been a treat to watch all night. And the overhand right counter of Ritu Phogat has come agonizingly close, a whisker away from connecting cleanly to the forehead or to the nose or philtrum of Lin Heqin.
Michael, you can see the way Ritu uses this wall is very sophisticated. She's able to trap Lin Heqin in this position, get her against the wall, and then secure these takedowns. Lin Heqin's got to, if she's able to get back up to her feet, but I don't know if she's gonna be able to at this point, she's got to keep her back off of that wall. She has to keep circling. She can't stay still and allow Ritu to back her up like this.
Under 3 minutes remaining. After a very good second 5 minutes from Ritu Phogat. Final 5 minutes is what we're in. And Ritu once again in control.
There's got to be some urgency here from Lin. She's got to get her back up against that wall and start scrambling to get back up. Because she's still got 2.5 minutes to put in some work here. She still has a chance in this matchup. But Ritu's just, once she gets you down, it is really hard to get Ritu off of you.
Ritu Phogat, who began training in wrestling as a 7-year-old. Her sisters, Gita and Babita, on whom the movie Dangal is based. Both won Commonwealth Games gold medals. They're both little sister Ritu's role models.
See, for Lin Heqin to be successful here, she has to get onto her side. Yeah, just like that. She cannot stay flat with her hips and her shoulders flat on the mat. Ritu's just too strong. She's got to keep digging those underhooks, create that movement, create that space.
Time is ticking away from Lin Heqin. You see Ritu wants to pin that left arm, drops an elbow, the corner called for it, she listened, so well done. Face exposed, picking these shots nicely, making sure they land.
Knuckles
turned in, full mount here from Ritu. Elbow again, the corner said elbow, elbow, and she just dropped it to the eyebrow.
That was nice, Michael. You see the way she was punching with her right hand and then moving her legs at the same time to advance her position? That's sophisticated ground and pound right there. The way she's able to do one thing with one side of her body and then do another with the other part. That's nice.
That's some cerebral GMP. Still in full mount, in control. Finding these openings that Lin is, well, not willingly, but still giving her. Applying pressure here, Ritu Phogat. High in the mount.
Trying to walk her way around. Oh, she's got her almost, she's almost out. She's got to create a little bit of movement. We got 30 seconds here for Lin Heqin to do something dramatic.
What could she do from here, Dragon?
I mean, there's possibly a triangle if she's able to get one of those arms down and look at it, but most likely it's not going to happen. Ritu's just, she's too dominant when things hit the ground. She knows exactly what she's doing and what position she needs to be in.
The final seconds, dominance over the last 5 minutes from Ritu Phogat. Is she back in the winner's circle tonight here in Singapore? On the ground, she is just amazing.
Ritu Phogat!